to Holo Holo. I'm Karen Iba with your daily dose of all things entertaining from Asia to Hollywood and everything in between. And of course, for spotlighting our very own talent. And joining us today is a singer-songwriter who has shared the stage with Sarah Bareilles, Sheryl Crow, Stevie Wonder. And you may also have recognized him on NBC's The Sing-Off. Meet Kenton Chen. Welcome.
Hello, it's good to be here.
Great to have you here. Now, first, take me back, because I hear that you started when you were really young, like 4 years old. Where did you find your passion for music?
Music has always been in my family. All four of my uncles did music. My dad was a violin teacher and a music pastor over at church. I grew up singing in church and playing violin.
But not just violin, you also play the piano.
I do. That my parents were not so strict about.
Oh, okay.
I actually picked that up because my sister took piano. Mm-hmm. So we had a piano at home and I would just kind of doodle all the time. Especially when I didn't want to practice violin, I would play piano instead.
Do you like piano better than violin or do you care?
I like piano a lot better. I do. I think just the fact that you can create chords.
Yes.
With piano.
Now let's talk about the Sing-Off, because I know you're in season two of the Sing-Off. Mm-hmm. How did that process go about?
Oh gosh, I was in the audience for season one, supporting my friend Kelly.
Okay.
And during the breaks. Right. The audience has like a participation because the judges are deliberating, and so they do these things for fun where they're like, oh, people come up, sing, like vote on your favorite person, and we'll come back next week and they'll sing. And basically what happened was I went up, and after that, one of the production staff you know, said, hey, can I get your number? And I'm like, oh, I don't want my number. Okay, cool. And he's like, oh, well, Ben Folds would really like to speak with you. Which was like...
Did you believe him or were you just saying?
Well, what's funny is that it really took 2 years for things to come to fruition. From there, one of the producers asked me, would you like to audition for the Sing-Off? And I said, yeah, sure, you know, it'd be fun. Let me put a group together. Let me, you know, I can't just take the group that I know because a lot of them were already on the show.
Yeah,
let's try to put something together. And it ended up being really, really fun. Do you know the game?
You've always had a passion for a cappella though, right?
Yeah, I would say. I did a lot of it in high school, and then in college I sang a cappella with the SoCal Vocals. I would say that looking back on it now, having had the perspective of being away from the group, because we were really, really tight on the show. But of course with anything, you grow apart, people are living in different areas in America, and I'd say, you know, it's still there. We don't keep in contact as much as we used to, but...
the friendships are still there.
The friendships are still there. It's about probably like 5 days ago, I was with all the Backbeats.
Oh my goodness. So you guys do still keep in touch.
Yeah, we had a reunion dinner. And
oh, that's awesome.
I mean, I haven't seen some of them for probably a year.
And now you're doing your own thing. You have an album coming out later this year. It's a three-part, right?
It's a three-part album. It's going to take a while because the creative process is really different from what I've ever done. I usually, you know, write, done, bam, record.
Yes.
Try to record. One album I recorded 14 songs in a day.
What?
It was
silly. In a day.
It was silly. It was very silly. Just the vocals. I mean, the band and all that stuff.
So what comes first? Is it the music or the lyrics?
It depends. Oftentimes, I basically have what is called a hook. And so it's like, for instance, one of my songs, let's say, is Enough. What I hear in my head is, and I'm like, okay. How does that make me feel? How does that make me feel? And then I come up with the words, oh, I just can't get enough. And then from there, then I start building the song. And I say, okay, what am I saying? What am I thinking of? Mm-hmm. Whereas Fierce Tears,
right, which is what you're going to perform.
Yes, which I'm going to perform. That was actually written about my friend who had a terminal illness. And of course, being a very awkward person, I didn't know how to really put the emotions that I had in words.
Right.
So I took my time. I probably wrote it over a week period. Mm-hmm. And I sang it for him, you know? And that's kind of where it came from. It's based off a poem. And so it's all fluid, you know? Words, music, it comes in and out. Sometimes the words come first.
Sometimes the music comes first. Well, I can't wait for you to perform Fierce Tears.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Now, for more information on you, where can we go?
Please go to my website. Uh-huh. That's at kentonchen.com. Mm-hmm. And I will have all my performances.
Yes.
My regular performances in Los Angeles,
right,
when I go on tour, promoting the album, all that stuff will be on my website, kentonchen.com.
And you're coming back for when you promote when your album comes out.
Yes.
Later this year.
Yes, I would love to come back.
Okay, thank you so much. We have to take a quick break, but can't wait to see you perform. Again, for more information on Kenton, his website is below. Stay tuned because he has a special performance just for us when we return.